Greeting. In this video, I will show you how to record a software simulation. First, click the Active Presenter button and select Record Software Simulation. After that, this dialog will appear. The left of the dialog is the recording area section. You can choose to record the whole screen by selecting the full screen option here. Or you can select custom to record just a specific part of it. This blue rectangle indicates that Active Presenter will record everything that happens inside of it, while ignoring the rest of the screen. You can freely drag any side or corner to change the captured size. You can also relocate the rectangle by dragging the crosshair to the designated point. Change the size of the recording area by adjusting the height and width index in the size spin boxes. Or you can choose one of the preset sizes from the drop-down list here. You can also lock the recording area to the application window by clicking the Lock to Application checkbox. This feature is designed to help users easily fit the recording area to the size of a specific application window. Thanks to that, users don't need to manually resize it. You can choose the locking mode by clicking this button and select one of the two options. The Fit to Boundary mode resizes the application window to fit the blue rectangle. On the other hand, the Fit to Application mode resizes the rectangle to fit the application window. After selecting the locking mode, choose the application you want to lock from the drop-down list here. After setting up the recording area, let's move to the audio section. Here you can choose whether to include audio or not by toggling the audio button. You can also pick the audio device you want to record by selecting from the drop-down list next to the audio button. Adjust the recording volume level by dragging the slider here. On the top right of the dialog, there's a setting icon. Click on it to reveal the setting menu with four options, as shown here. Now I will make an example by recording how to insert, resize and crop a video in Microsoft PowerPoint. Start recording by clicking on the red button here. Wait 3 seconds before it begins. Now let's check out this recording toolbar and see what it does. On the left side, there are three informative sections. The statistics section shows the project statistics, which includes the mode displays the current recording project mode, which can be video or slide. Notice that whenever you scroll the mouse or carry a drag and drop action, Active Presenter will automatically switch to the video mode to capture it. Otherwise, it will switch back to the previous capture mode, which is slide. The recorded shows the current recorded slide number and slide mode. It will change to frames in video mode, which in case shows the number of frames recorded. The dropped shows the number of missed frames in the recorded video. Next is the duration section, which shows the current duration of the recorded project. This audio section displays the audio sound level. You can click the settings icon here to toggle the statistics, duration, audio, and webcam section. On the right side of the toolbar, there are three buttons. The first one is the pause, resume button. Click on it to temporarily pause the recording, and re-click to continue the process. The last one is the discard recording button. It will give you three options after you click it. As you select discard, all the simulation recorded will be deleted, and you will go back to the original window. Select recapture if you want to start the recording over again. In case you are having second thoughts about discarding, click continue to keep on going. Finally, click the Stop Recording button in the middle when you finish. After that, the recorded project will show a series of slides, which containing steps that you have carried out. As a result, all actions on screen will be converted into a slide-based project. Active Presenter can automatically create slide names, smart annotations, cursor paths, mouse clicks, keystrokes, text boxes, and feedback messages. Therefore, you can save yourself a lot of time and effort in the editing phase. Otherwise, freely change it the way you want. Refer to this video for more editing instruction. Finally, after you have finished editing, export the project to HTML5, which is the most suitable output format for interactive simulation. With HTML5 exporting, learners can view and interact with the content. Meanwhile, if you want to create training manuals, exporting the project to document formats is a more suitable choice. That's it for today. Hope you find the video helpful and feel free to ask us if anything is not clear. Thank you for watching.